What's going on, guys? This is Qazi. Welcome back to another epic video. This time, I just wanted to make color grading simple and effective. Okay, what I mean by that is there's tons of deep divers on my channel, so you guys can just drink and swim in that Kool-Aid, take your time with it. But with this particular video, I am coming from a point of view of like a Final Cut Pro user or a Premiere Pro user, somebody who is living in a different world than DaVinci Resolve. And if this is your first time jumping into it, how can you start dominating instead of just like, you know, doing some cute things? But the way I'm gonna be accomplishing this is gonna be so simple that you can genuinely create these looks in minutes. This will also show you the power of color grading just by touching it a little bit, that what you can do from the same image, same shot, how many different moods you can create, but with the built-in DNA. It's not like a cake on look. It's gonna be something that we're gonna be creating from ground up. And for those that wanna level up their color grading game, check out the link in the description, 1 hour long free training where I will show you how to get the perfect skin tones out of your Sony S-Log 8-bit footage, how to get the clean white look, it's the go-to commercial look, how to get the creamy film look, how to fix the dreaded gamma shift, and much, much more. Link is in the description. On that note, guys, smash that like button. You know how YouTube works. You got to smash that like button if you want me to continue making these videos and if we want to make a bigger impact. Smash it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Follow me on Instagram. I'm dropping value bombs there every single day. Let's roll the intro. Guys, get super excited because this is gonna blow your mind. What I'm about to show you, it does not matter. If this is your first time opening Resolve and if you just bring your clip in and this is what you're looking at, I'm gonna show you how to make magic, okay? And like you saw, we're gonna be creating three different looks. Now, these genres are interchangeable, okay? The horror could be action, action could be horror. You can do this multiple different ways. But I'm just about to show you the true power of color grading and what's at your fingertips and how we can get that in minutes. So are you pumped? Let's just jump right in, okay? This is not a deep dive. This is just a quick process of showing you how to create something really magical. And I'm gonna break down the concept a little bit too. So first of all, let's just park on our hero frame. And I think it's gonna be somewhere around 2 seconds. This right here, we see her skin and then everything that we need to see in the shot, okay? So why did I pull this all the way to the right? Because this is gonna be my look DNA. This is where I'm going to determine what the final image should look like in terms of the contrast and the push and pull we wanna do. And then we're gonna go back and reverse engineer it and create different genres and different looks and all that stuff, okay? So let me explain what I'm talking about. So what we're going to do, as always, come into right here in our contrast and pivot, and I'm just going to start it off with my contrast. So let's go ahead. I'm going to give it a little bit of contrast, some, you know, keep it somewhere around here, and then I'm going to take my pivot and I'm going to raise it a little bit, not too much. So now I start to see her face and it's looking nice, and I'm keeping it somewhere around here. Now, when you do it this way, contrast and pivot, the beautiful thing about it is that it creates a really gentle S-curve, which gives you this film-like curves on the bottom and the high end. Look, it's really, really soft, okay? And that's what I want. I'm going for this film look. So even if I push it a little bit more and then I go back into my pivot and raise it up a little bit, I don't want to raise it too much because I'm going to start losing saturation. So I'm going to keep it somewhere around here. And, you know, this to me is looking pretty good, okay? Again, I'm trying to simplify this entire process for you, so I'm gonna leave that there. Now, there's tons of blue here, right? So we're already in our horror world, you know, zone. We don't need to go any further, but let's just say if we wanna, you know, push it a bit more, I'm gonna show you the easiest way to do that. So just like what you're familiar with in your Lightroom, temperature and tint, Premiere Pro has that too. So we're going to be basically relying on this and be doing most of our heavy lifting using these two, okay, right here. So I can just go into my temperature and go, okay, what do I want to do with it? Do I want to give it more blue, or do I want to get, you know, neutralize it a little bit? But in this one, I want to give it more blue. So I'm going to keep it somewhere around here. And then let's go on our tint. And do we want to add more green into our blue, which will make it like a modern blue? Or do we want to make it like a Terminator 2 blue, which is a little bit more on the magenta side? And I think I want to keep it somewhere around that, you know, Terminator blue kind of thing, because it just looks cool, because, you know, it's something that we don't see very often. So I'm going to keep it somewhere around here, because I also want to pay attention to the skin, but we do want to blend it. We don't want to pull it out. Now, let's say this is our look. We created it, right? So our blue channel is dominant. We can see it. And then red is compressed. Now, one thing that I want to do is I want to pull my jacket out, right? Because I don't want the jacket to be the casualty of this entire look. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click here and I'm going to say, hey, give me a layer mixer. Okay. And what that does is that in here, what I can do is I can just click on this guy, qualifier, so I can qualify it. And then I'm just going to brush through here. And I'm going to hit Shift H, and look, it does a great job pulling this out. And now let's just add a little bit of denoise, something like that. We don't need to do it anymore. And now if I turn this on and off, we see that it's pulling it out quite a bit. Now let's just, you know, make it a bit more, you know, film-like, right? Like, I mean, we don't want it to be realistic. If it's realistic, it's boring. So let's just give it some pizzazz. So what I want to do is I'm going to go into my gamma, or let's just do my offset. And I want to put that, I want to put more yellow in there. And then what I want to do is I want to go into my contrast, and I just want to give it some juice, right? But I want to give it juice by adding editable splines. I'm going to click right here, and I want to raise it a little bit, right? Not too much. I still want it to kind of blend in. And instead of adding saturation to saturate it, I'm going to use my offset to keep adding more color. And you'll see what I mean. And maybe somewhere around here. So I'm going to keep it somewhere around here. So look at how easily we were able to pull that out, give it so much color. And guys, look at this node tree. Is this the simplest thing you've ever seen or what? And we're done, because again, skin, we want to blend it in to that world. Okay, this is horror, and we want to take the life out of the skin and the environment. So I want to leave everything as is. And now if I just play it through, we were able to create that literally in minutes. Like I said, why did I create the first node? The first node is there for noise reduction. If you want to add it, go for it. You know, you can add grain too. But those are going to be extracurricular. If you just want to get going in Resolve and just wow your Premiere Pro and Final Cut 10 friends, then you got it. Okay, so this is our first look. I'm jumping right in. Let's create our second look, but we're going to do it in a smart way. Now, let me show you something. If you're looking at my parade and going, man, this is not that far from log. Like, why aren't you maximizing your parade, your histogram, and like really push it? Let me show you something, right? So think of some of your favorite films. Let's just pull up Blade Runner. I'm going to pull this up right here. Look at where Blade Runner is sitting. Wasn't it one of the best looking movies you have ever seen? Look at where it sits on the scope. So let's just go and look at the next still. Look at where this sits. Look at where this sits. Even the daytime shots, look at where they're maxing out. So this, like, look at this. So this gets to give you a perspective, an idea to, you know, where you get most of the meat. You want to keep your images in that world if you want to get the most out of them and just have this, you know, illusion of like unlimited dynamic range, if you will. So that's our first look. Okay, we're pushing it. Now, don't get freaked out about, man, this is way too blue, out of my comfort zone, because I'm going to give you a drama version, which is going to be more of like the safe, or, you know, keeping it looking realistic look, which is our second look. So let's create that right now. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go under my stills. Let me just delete these really quick. I'm going to go in here and I'm going to go ahead and save this still. So right click and save. What this does is that this turns it into a power grid. Now, if I take all of these and if I just delete them and then I go, oh my God, I just lost everything. How can I bring it back? I can go click on this and boom, it brings it right back, because this is a power grade. Okay, so this is a very, very powerful tool. When you create these looks, always grab these stills, because then you're grabbing the entire node tree and then you can apply it on your next project or whatever it is that you're working on. Okay, so that was our first look and we saved it. Now I'm also going to save it as a version. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and, you know, save it as a version. And now we're creating our second look, which is dramatic look. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave everything else as is. I'm just going to delete this node. I'm even going to leave this as is because we got to work smart, not hard. And now all I got to do is go back to my temperature and tint. And now I'm going to create that normal, you know, like a drama look. So basically for the drama look, let's pull a lot of that blue out and make it looking, you know, realistic, like normal. And then do I want more green? Do I want more magenta? I just really want it to be. So basically, this is our drama. Maybe I can add a little bit more magenta. And I'm looking at our white points, right? So if I'm looking at this, this is looking pretty good to me. This is looking pretty proper to me. So that's my, you know, or drama look. But let's say if I want to bring the reds up a little bit more and get them closer, let's just push it. Let's see what happens, right? So I can go here, something like that. And then let's see. I can, because I just really want to see what can happen, right? So now if I go back to what I had to what I have now, if you think that this is a bit too much, then we can pull it back a little bit. Again, focusing on the white point. And maybe it's looking good here. And once again, guys, I'm restricting this entire thing to just temperature and tint, okay? I'm not getting fancy with it. Like, of course, you've seen my other tutorials that can get really involved. Here, I just want to give you an example. I want to give you permission to just get started, get going, okay? And create really impeccable looks by doing barely anything, okay? So now this is our second look. But let's just say that, you know, when we look at this, it feels a bit more pushed compared to this. It feels a bit too, you know, soft. If you want to give it a little bit more punch, then we can go back in here into our DNA and we can start cranking the contrast a little bit more, just a little bit, not too much. And then pull it back. Maybe that much, right? So now I go here and now I go here and this is looking pretty good. And guys, this is my drama look, okay? So you pick and choose whichever one is your favorite. This is my second one. I'm going to right click here and I'm going to say grab still. And then the beautiful thing about stills is that I can come in here and click on this guy. And now I can get to see the two looks that I created back to back and see like how different they are, right? Or I can even like do something like this and like really see how much of a difference I made. And I mean, you can see we're making huge difference just by doing barely anything. So it's all about the concept. It's all about analyzing your shot. And then what do you want to do with it? This is the power, true power of color grading. So now we've saved our second version. So I'm going to go ahead and kill this again. But you know what? Now I want to work off of this because remember we made some changes to our DNA. So I'm just going to go back to this and I'm going to work off of this. So I'm going to go ahead in here and I'm going to create another version. I'm going to get rid of this. I'm going to leave everything as is. And this is going to be our action look. And action is going to be opposite of this look that we created, meaning our green channels are going to be dominant. So let's start doing that. So I'm going to pull this up a little bit. Something like that. I'm not going to go too far with it. So let's just bring it somewhere around here. Now I'm going to take my green and I'm going to push it. I'm still focusing on the skin, but I really want to create like an extreme sort of look, you know? So I'm going to go there. I'm going to push this down and I'm going to go more green. And I'm just looking at that and I really want to put some green in there. Like, almost think about like old film, how it would have so much green in the highlights. And I want to put that in. You know, something like that. And, you know, we're pushing it, right? We're blending in the face quite a bit. Now, if skin is just an ultimate killer for you and you're like, dude, this is way too much, I do need to pull the skin a little bit, then you can create another node in here, layer mixer, and just go pick this out. And now if I pull this out, I can restrict it quite a bit. And then again, really get in there, right? And just like that. And now all I need to do is just give it a little bit denoise. And now all I need to do here is go into my gamma and subtract that blue. And basically what I need to do is just really like, this is enough, not too much. This is enough. Like, it's just enough to pull her out, but not where, you know, it just, it turns into like overly stylized, like boom, just enough. Okay. Maybe even less. So something like that, right? Barely anything, but just does the trick. Like that. Enough. Again, extracurricular. If you needed to blend it, then you could have just left it as is. It was totally fine. Now, what I can do is, these are the three different looks that I've created. And now if I go here and save this one as well, I can just click on it and say grab still. We can really, if I just grab these two, and go in here, click on this guy and say, hey, show me all my selected stills. We can really get to see the three looks that we've created. And just, guys, look at it. I mean, come on. The difference in all these three looks and how simple and easy and fast it was to create that. Now, what we did here, you can also apply it here and pull the skin out. Okay, a little bit. But again, it was not necessary, but I just wanted to show you an additional step, extracurricular, somebody that just wants to do that to get it right. But how simple was this? How effective was it? Just, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know. The message here is that there is beauty in simplicity, and hope the message got across. Let's check out the final look in full screen. So I hope this cleared things up for you guys, how simple color grading can be and how effective it can be at the same time. But there's so many ways to approach the same thing. It's so subjective, but at the same time, you gotta get started. You gotta get going. So many people are waiting for the perfect monitor, waiting to future-proof themselves for HDR. Just get started, man. Everything that you pick up along the way is gonna move you closer to your goal. So do not forget to check out the link in the description if you wanna level up your color grading game. Smash that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in the next video.